08. What up, what up? Bike is dirty as shit. Need to wash it. Give it a little bit of love. But I'm kind of lazy. And I don't have a garage. So I'm not parked at my workshop then. This is a beautiful mansion back here. This is all some dude's property. This whole fencing area. It looks like a state park or something right up here, his entrance. Look at that shit. That's badass. I also bought a wireless mic setup for doing like still shot or studio shot stuff where I wear like a wireless mic. So I can walk around or whatever and be talking, and hopefully the sound quality will be better on my next video coming up on my shack restoration. Sun is bright as fuck. My dude's out riding today. Father's everywhere. I got a lot of topics that I'll probably be covering here. Like I said, this whole idea of the MotoVlog kind of appeals to me because I ride a lot, and a lot of times by myself because I'm riding to work. I ride back and forth to work most 3 or 4 days a week, and weather depending. So kind of whatever pops in my head. And I talk to myself, when I'm riding anyway, so fuck. Might as well do this. And hopefully, I don't know, we'll see what happens. So I guess I'll talk about this bike a little bit. This is my first bagger. I've had a lot of different bikes over the years. And I thought I needed an old man bike. Now that I'm single. You know, something that, to be honest, chicks wouldn't mind jumping on the back, feel comfortable, and want to go for a ride. And, I did not want a Harley Davidson, for my own personal reasons, but, it just seems like everybody has a fucking Harley Davidson, and, you know, I've worked on Harleys for a while. I had a custom motorcycle shop where we built Harley bait custom choppers. And I competed in the world championships of bike building back in like 2008, I guess. That was almost 10 years ago. And I just kind of like the victory. I like the way they look. I really like the way they look compared to the Harleys. I mean, it's the fucking Harleys, man. They've just been around for so long. The designs haven't really changed, and they all look the same, and everybody customizes them the same with the, you know, the whole big wheel, front wheel thing's cool, I guess, but, what the fuck is that? You know, I kind of equate this bike to looking kind of more like a Cadillac. You know, CTS or something, you know, with its sharp angular edges, and it just kind of spoke to me more, and I like the, you know, 5-year warranty, unlimited mileage warranty, and, you know, I don't know about it, big motor. I like these crazy forged crash bars, which I've used like fucking 3 times. I've dropped this bitch in the parking lot, some, you know, silly sometimes. So there's, you know, a few weird quirks about this bike that I think Victory should probably fix. But they're minor things, you know. One of them, off the top of my head, is the gas gauge. It'll read full and three quarter, and then once it gets to about half, that's pretty half. Once it gets to about half, it starts dropping like a fucking rock. And next thing you know, you're empty. And it seems like the calibration's off or something. I don't trust anybody that's going to pull out in front of me, so I don't know. You probably notice anytime there's a car that wants to kill me like that, I like swerve like this, or I'll flash my fucking high beams at them. I'll do something to try to get their attention. You'd be like, hey, motherfucker. You know, like this guy, he can't see me because of the fucking tree. You know, so I just kind of swerve a little bit and be like, hey, I'm crazy. I'm a crazy motorcyclist. Don't fucking pull out in front of me. I'm going to kick your ass, kind of thing. Even though, you know, probably not going to happen. So I'll probably be dead and laying on the side of the road. Well, that was nice. Give it away now. One of the other complaints that I hear about this bike is the transmission is super clunky, and I just equate that to a Harley Davidson. So were Harley Davidsons, and I almost feel like they did it on purpose, because I mean, I don't know, it's just my hypothesis, but, you know, they're trying to get Harley riders to jump over and buy a Victory. They're going to probably want to do something that, you know, are similar to a Harley. We are in shit town right now. We are in downtown Sanford. Little Sanford Marina here. People hanging out on this beautiful Sunday afternoon. Such a lonely day. That's alright. These are the days of my life. Alright, I'll spare you the singing. Man, it's a nice out. So when I came around, it was around that side of the lake. We've basically gone all the way around the lake here on this little ride here. That can't be good. Oh man, I'm getting restless. Fuck! Ready for a drink. I need like a good ice cold Coca-Cola or something. My throat's all dry. I need one of those little things so I can just sip water or something while I'm riding, like I used to have on my mountain bike. Well, 2017, man, I'm still pondering that. You know, it was kind of a rough year, 2016, for me and for a lot of people. I got divorced, and that was a long time coming, and I'm glad it's over. And I'm actually heading to my ex-wife's house right now to have dinner with my kids and her. And we've done, I think, a pretty phenomenal job of staying friends and, you know, showing our children that, you know, divorce doesn't have to, you know, devastate families. You know, we're not living together anymore, but we're still a family. We still have to raise these our three beautiful children, and I know a lot of people go through it, and you know, my advice for that would certainly be try to compromise and sweet bus, bro. And, you know, do what you can to make life better for everybody.
What's up, yo?
Hammer down. Happy New Year! Yeah, that diaper on. 2017. It's going to be a new year for me. I kind of settled into my new place, the shack that I've been restoring for a year now or so, a year and a half actually, and finished up a few more things on that, and then I'm going to start working on my 1968 Lincoln Continental project that's been kind of on hold for quite a few years now. I started on it, and I tinkered on it here and there. The last couple of years, did a few things, but all right, well, I'm going to sign off, but until next time, I'm going to try to post one of these at least once a week, and try to be consistent with it. Probably post on Wednesdays, and Monday and Tuesday nights are always a good night for me at home to sit here and edit videos and kind of put things together. So if you like it, you know, like and share and hit the little bell button down there to get the notifications when I put up new videos. And, you know, share with your friends, like it, subscribe. And I need to get my subscriber base built up and watch my other videos. I'm kind of got a diverse range of things that I do that I've been videoing. And so I would appreciate it. Have a great new year, everybody. 2017, let's kick its fucking ass. Get your side hustle on, get your main hustle on, whatever it is that you do. Fucking bust ass. Don't take any fucking shit from anybody. Do your thing, do what you love, do what your passion is. You know? Don't just do shit for money or, you know, because you have to. Do it because you fucking love it. And that's when the shit happens. You know, when you're just doing it because you want to, because you just, you got that drive to get up out of bed in the morning and, you know, go make something, go, you know, do whatever it is that makes you happy, you know, go volunteer at the soup kitchen, go fucking throw pops on the potter's wheel, do it, you know, go for a motorcycle ride, whatever it is, whatever your passion is, do it, man, and do it fucking, do it badass, do it as well and as good as you can and try to be the best at it. Life isn't all about making money. There's a lot more to life than that. I know, I can tell you that firsthand because I know a lot of people that have a lot of money and they're not happy, you know? So everybody's so friendly. All right, guys. Peace. 2017. I'm out.